I'm Fraser Cain, the publisher of Universe Today. The universe is enormous. In the observable universe, there are more than 170 billion galaxies. In our galaxy alone, there are as many as 400 billion stars, and most probably have planets. A few of those planets must contain useful minerals for life and fall within the star's habitable zone where liquid water is present. Based on this, many believe the conditions for life exist throughout the universe. So where are all the aliens? The universe has been around for 13.8 billion years. Humanity got its start a mere 200,000 years ago, only 0.01% of the age of the universe. There's been plenty of time for an intelligent species to arise on any one of countless worlds and broadcast their existence to the entire galaxy. Or perhaps, if a species developed interstellar travel, they could completely colonize our galaxy within a few tens of millions of years. That's only a heartbeat in the age of the universe. We've got the potential for life everywhere and an incredible span of time for it to migrate itself all around the universe. Yet, as far as we know, Earth is the only place in the entire universe where life has arisen, let alone developed an intelligent civilization. So where are all the aliens? This baffling contradiction is known as the Fermi Paradox, first described in 1950 by the physicist Enrico Fermi. Scientists have been trying to resolve this mystery for decades, listening for radio signals from other worlds. They sampled only a fraction of the radio spectrum, and to date, haven't detected anything that could be a signal from an intelligent species. So what are our options? It could be that we're the only planet in the entire universe to develop life. Perhaps we're the first civilization to reach this level of advancement in the entire universe. For assuming there's life with so many worlds out there, both seem unlikely. Or civilizations destroy themselves when they reach a certain point. Nuclear weapons, global warming, killer epidemics, and overpopulation could all end humanity. Asteroids could strike the planet and wipe us out. But would this happen to every single civilization? 100% of them? Even if 99% of civilizations destroy themselves, we could still have a couple that make it through to fully colonize the galaxy. And if they're actual aliens, why haven't we met them? Perhaps they're just too far away and our signals can't reach each other. But why wouldn't they just build self-replicating probes that could traverse those distances and leave a local artifact in every single star system? Maybe we haven't the ability to receive their signals or recognize their artifacts. Sure, but if aliens constructed a series of artifacts on Earth, I think we'd notice them. I'd like to assume that if they've mastered space travel, they'd have experience creating obvious structures. They could just be too alien and we can't understand them. Or we're too insignificant and they don't think we're worth talking to. But we don't need to talk to them to know they exist. If they flew through our solar system, ignoring us, we'd still know they're around. Perhaps they're not talking to us on purpose, and we're really in some kind of galactic zoo, or aliens have a prime directive, and they're not allowed to talk to us. Maybe some aliens have these rules, but all of them? Not a single sympathetic alien has broken the rules and snuck us some evidence? There are many other potential solutions to the Fermi Paradox, but I find them all lacking. The universe is big and old, and if extraterrestrial life is anything like us, it wants to multiply and spread out. The most unsettling idea is that something happens to 100% of intelligent civilizations and that prevents them from exploring and settling the galaxy. Maybe it's something good, like the discovery of a transportation system to another universe. Or maybe it's something bad, like a destructive technology or a discovery that has destroyed every single civilization before us. How do you feel about the Fermi Paradox? And how do you propose that we resolve the contradictions? Whatever the solution is, it sure is fun to think about. Thanks for watching. Thanks for watching. Now make sure you click subscribe on our YouTube channel over here. And maybe you've still got some questions about space and astronomy, like this one or that one. And if you don't see the question you're looking for, then send me an email at info@universetoday.com.